Yo.
What is up, Stuart? How are you, my friend?
I'm good, man. I'm better today than I was yesterday.
Are you?
I had a challenging morning with one of my kiddos, and I didn't react in the best way. So I had to have some connection time with my man and do some apologies.
Yeah, how'd that go?
Good. I mean, the apology was good. The reaction ahead of time, that I had to apologize for was not so good. So I'm learning, man. I'm learning. I'm been struggling a little bit in the dad department, with how I react specifically with my son. He likes to poke the bear. He knows how to get to me.
Yeah, man. We have been doing these little walks around the building, having some pretty deep conversations. They're usually short, hard hitting on the issues that we're trying to work through. And yesterday, coincidentally, we had a conversation. We had a conversation, but we also did a podcast, and we had an amazing guest. And this will I'm not sure if it's going to come up before or after, but Grace Marshall, and we just talked through some things on struggle, and we talked about self-awareness and a number of these things. And the same day you had your struggle with your son, I had a dad victory. The situations were very similar that we were facing, but my dudes just fight. My daughter doesn't, but my dudes just fight. Getting up in the morning, getting ready for school, and like every day now, my little dude is like, oh, I'm not going to school. And you're like, well, yes, you are. And the way I react to it and handle it is very different than the way my wife does. But yesterday I implemented, I did something that just changed everything for me. And it has been changing it a lot for me lately. And it's this idea of just walking away. And taking a deep breath, right? And it's funny because you hear this count to 10, count to 5. You hear these things your entire life growing up. You hear about just taking a break, taking a step, take deep breath, all these different things, right? But like, as I thought about it, I'm like, I don't remember actively doing those things.
Yeah.
Right? I don't
Well,
remember,
it's
like,
hard.
it's hard, right? And I don't remember actually implementing that stuff. And so for my middle guy, my wife is like, oh, it's easy to get him up because he loves walking with his friends to the bus in the morning. And so my wife's like, hey, do you want to walk to the bus or do you want me to take you to school? Because we can like take our kids to school now too. And he's like, oh, I want to ride the bus. And he gets up and he gets like, she came up with that. And I'm like, that's so easy, right? But she typically has more tools and better tools than I do, but for me, it required to step back and take a breath and be like, okay, it doesn't have to be a war. It doesn't have to be my will versus your will. You get up because I said you get up, and that's just what you do. That's your job in this house, is to go to school. Like, that is an approach. That is one I've often used, and I kind of revert back to. But yesterday, for my kid, my youngest guy, so I said that to my middle guy. He got up and no issue, like super easy. Which is a new experience. But my little dude, I went in there and I'm like, and he just woke up like a rattlesnake, dude. He's like, what was like kind of even hitting me, which is very atypical. Like, that's not something that is a big struggle, like him being physical, because my kids like, well, and part of it is, because in the past, like if you're physical with dad, like, dude, it's just not gonna go very well for you. And because I always saw it as a challenge of wills, right? But yesterday I was like, okay, I stepped out of the room. I didn't even have to take that long, but I stepped out. And in that short time, it came to me, like, instead of getting mad and responding to what he was doing, it came to me. I'm like, dude loves when I give him piggyback rides, like, loves it. He's always asking for piggyback rides. So I went back in. I'm like, come here, my dude. I love you. And I hugged him, and I was kind of like, smushing him, kind of tickly, making him laugh, but he was still grumpy. I'm like, hey, dude, I could take you downstairs like a koala bear. You could try to hold on to my chest, or I could give you a piggyback ride. What do you want? And dude, like that, it changed, right? It changed immediately. And he was like, I want a piggyback ride. I was like, oh, okay, cool. Now, the only reason I highlight that is it required me to get up to walk away because my natural tendency was coming to light and I wanted to crush him. But I was like, dude, just walk away for a sec. Don't start the morning this way. I walked out. Literally, I walked out of his room. He doesn't have a huge room. It took 1 second to walk out. I was like, oh, okay. I walked back in and everything was different, right? Everything was different because I gave him an offer that cost me nothing. It's a piggyback ride. He's 7, right? It's easy and it's fun. He jumped on. I like ran down the stairs like, oh man, if I trip, dude, we're in trouble. But it just made it fun. He's laughing and it's crazy. And I'm not saying like it's kumbaya and he was in a great mood after that. And he was a great, you know, great kid after that. He wasn't, but it took us out of that moment and it got us moving forward. And we both were getting the objective that we both wanted was being met.
Yeah, dude, I love it, man. It's funny. I was listening to a podcast yesterday on my way to go pick up my kids, and it wasn't even a parenting podcast. I think it was like a business real estate podcast, but they started talking about being a dad, and the guest, I'm blanking on the name of the podcast right now, but the guest started talking about being a dad, and he said that he actually him and his wife got a parenting coach, and because he was struggling in this area. And I wrote it down and he said this one phrase and it like really hit me. And it sounds kind of like what you did. He says, we have a rule in our house that there is no correction without connection first. Mm. No correction without connection first. And so he gave this example kind of similar, like, you know, kids being a butthead and you want to correct them, but instead of correcting them first, be like, hey buddy, like what's going on? How's your day? How you doing? Everything going okay? And like, maybe give him a hug and like what, you know, offer a piggyback ride. Right. And so I took that and, you know, in my apology yesterday afternoon, I made the attempt to connect first, and apologize and, you know, talked about the situation and then gave some ideas and thoughts on how it went. And, it was great, man. It was great. And, so definitely a lesson learned for me, a dad fail, turned it around and, you know, hopefully I can learn from it and make better choices on how I react, in the future. So love the idea of walking away. You know, we've had a guest, Ben Colloy, talk about, you know, being the calmest heartbeat in the room. I think all those are really good ways to look at, parenting. And how we react.
Yeah, man. And a lot of times our reaction says more about us than it says about our kid. And it just takes a level of self-awareness and intentionality to be like, okay, what, like for me, like I have to dig into the question of why do I feel like I need to control or why does it have to be my way? Right. And a lot of us, I think, dismiss that as, well, I'm the dad, so it should be my way. Well, you're a fallible human being, dad, man. Yes. Is your way always the right way? And I'll tell you, Noah's way yesterday, giving him the piggyback ride, like I enjoyed that more than my way. I enjoyed that more than the authoritarian, like, dude, because I said to get up and because you go to school, like that's what you do. Yeah. Like, I've said that.
It doesn't work that normally.
Thousands of times, right? Because I have 3 kids and he's the youngest. I've said that multiple times. Well, you're going to do it because that's, you know, whatever it is, but to connect with him, to hear his laughter and for him to like hold on to me, wrap around my neck and us play around and I'm running around with him on my back, that is much more preferable, if I'm honest, than just being right. Or you do it because I said, cause I'm your dad. Like, you know, and there's a time and a place. I'm not suggesting that's I'm not making judgment on that. I'm just simply saying I've been on both sides of that equation. Right. And I prefer to be on the side. I love the language of, you know, one of the things we talk about is naming these things so that you can connect with it more quickly and act appropriately to what you desire. And I love that connecting before correcting, right? Because there's not, and even when you talk about apologizing, dude, my parents never apologized to me.
No.
My dad would never apologize. The closest I can even remember is like, hey, I'm about to whoop you with this belt and it's because I love you. Like, that's the closest, right? Like, it's because I love you. Okay. It doesn't feel that way, but here we go. And the idea of taking a pause, why not apologize? Like, and I think it's a very critical question, because oftentimes the answers we're going to come up with are the merits of it far outweigh the reasons not to. Like, for example, you're just modeling. You demand, yeah. I'm assuming you demand of your kids to apologize to their siblings when they do something, right?
Yep. 100%.
Well, you're modeling that. Hey, dude, can we not acknowledge, like, as a parent, you know, I'm 44, my kid's 7. I lose my mind on my kid. Which one of us should have control of our, which one of us should have more self-control, the 7-year-old or the 44-year-old? Like, if you intentionally ask these questions, you come to the realization, you're like, okay, my way is not always right. My reaction is not necessarily, do I react that way with other people that annoy me? No, I don't. Okay, do I love them as much as I love my son? Absolutely not. All right, what's the disconnect? What's going on here? And that level of self-awareness can really teach you some things about yourself, which I think is always the goal. It's always the goal. So if you choose not to apologize to your kids, that's fine. Just acknowledge why you don't. And if it's a pride issue, well, maybe that's something you want to address. Maybe it's not. If it's some other deeper seated issue, then that you don't want to address, you just want to let it lay and let the fruit of that seed sprout in your life, then cool. But at least do it knowingly. At least choose, I want to keep the seed of anger because I love the fruits that anger produces in my life. Yeah. Just keep it, just own it, right? Be honest about it and keep it, or do something about it and change it. Because no matter what, if it is a seed of anger, and it produces fruits of anger, you're passing that on to your children, and you may be creating the environment and setting the foundations of the relationship you're going to have with your kid for the rest of your life. And are you cool with that? If you are, then cool. If you're not, then cool. Do something about it, right? Either way, do something about it. So I love that. I love the apology. I love the simple, the simplicity of connection before correction. That can be valuable through all your relationships. And just like stepping away, taking a deep breath. If you learn to do that in all your interactions, it gives you an upper hand, quite frankly. It gives you an upper hand.
Yeah, man. Love it, dude. Love it. I will take action on those and become a better dad for it. Good stuff, man.
And a better friend. Like, I think a lot of room. I mean, and I'm not saying this is judgy. I'm just telling you, as your best friend, I'm telling you out of love, like, you have a ton of room to grow as a friend. Like, and I'm saying that in a loving way, right? Like,
thanks, man.
You have,
I love you too.
Ample opportunities to be better as a friend. If you're wondering.
I wasn't, but thank you for offering.
But now, but then I give it to you for free. Thanks, man. Give that to you for free.
Go take action. Uncommon action. Be better. Be different. Be kinetic. See you.
Giddy up.